This morning, one man attacked outside a northern suburb sporting complex. Police search for clues. Feeling the heat, leaders discuss Australia's climate change policies at the Pacific Islands Forum. The latest on WA's COVID outbreak, why experts say we might need the return of mask mandates. And an epic state of origin decider, the Maroons dig deep to beat the Blues.
This is 7 Morning News, live from Perth, with Syan Vallance.
Good morning. A 20-year-old man has suffered cuts to his body after being attacked by 4 people in Madley. It happened near Hepburn Avenue, close to the club rooms for the netball and football fields. Kate Massey has the details.
Good morning. It's not clear how serious the man's injuries are. We do know he suffered cuts and abrasions, but the investigation is still ongoing. This incident happened around 6 o'clock last night at the Kingsway Sporting Complex, usually a pretty busy sporting complex here in Madeley too. Police say the 20-year-old was near the club rooms for the netball and football fields when he was approached and attacked by 4 unknown men. He was injured in this incident. As I mentioned, he suffered lacerations. Some of his belongings were stolen too. It's understood these individuals might have broken into another vehicle prior to this incident as well. 2 people are assisting police with their inquiries, but this investigation is ongoing, so if you have any information, CCTV or dash cam footage that could help detectives, the advice is to contact Crime Stoppers.
Thanks, Kate. Anthony Albanese is set to feel the heat today at the Pacific Islands Forum in Fiji as Australia's climate change commitments come under the microscope. The Prime Minister is using the trip to set about mending relationships in the Pacific.
Good morning. Well, it's been smooth sailing so far for Anthony Albanese during his first trip to the Pacific as Prime Minister. It was all smiles this morning at the official family photo of this Pacific Islands Forum, Anthony Albanese alongside leaders of Pacific nations. But then it was straight down to business with the leaders' meeting. That discussion held behind closed doors to allow frank and open discussion on the future of the Pacific. And while China has dominated discussions so far, this Pacific Islands Forum, many leaders want to bring the focus back to climate change, which is presenting a very real and present threat to their home nations. And while the Foreign Minister has been quick to point out the government's new policy on climate change has been welcomed by the Pacific, some leaders privately believe Australia can and should be more ambitious with its climate targets. Fiji's Prime Minister saying so publicly, tweeting, "Australia's new climate pledge is a step up, but out of the duty I owe every young person in the Pacific, I have urged Anthony Albanese to go further." The Prime Minister saying Australia went into this meeting prepared to listen.
We need to reassure our Pacific friends that we're concerned about their development, that we're concerned about the issues that they're confronting, particularly climate change, which is a threat to their very existence, and that our support comes without strings attached. It's part of our responsibility as good neighbours.
Pacific posturing was cast aside last night, however, with Anthony Albanese hosting other Pacific leaders watching the state of origin from here in Suva. We're told many of the island leaders are, in fact, Queensland supporters, so they've got one up on Anthony Albanese for now.
There's growing concern that if Indonesia's foot and mouth disease outbreak reaches Australian shores, it could unleash a crisis on our farming industry. There are now calls for tougher border controls for travellers from Bali.
It could take just one person getting off a flight from Bali and carrying the disease for it to take hold in Australia with devastating consequences. Foot and mouth disease affects pigs and cattle and sheep, and it's taken hold across Indonesia for the first time in more than 40 years. Now, a couple of flights have arrived here this morning from Bali, and passengers who were on board have told us that biosecurity officers did come on board to make sure they knew what to do to ensure they weren't spreading the virus to Australia. They've been told to do things like declare where they've been, make sure they've avoided livestock while they were in the country, and to clean their shoes and their clothes as well of soil to make sure they're not bringing the disease with them. And we spoke with a number of passengers who said they were taking extra measures.
We just avoided rural areas, made sure our shoes were clean.
I hope they're being very, very careful because we're livestock farmers, and We're really worried about the foot and mouth disease and hope everyone's taking it very seriously.
Now, if the disease did make it to Australia, it could cost the livestock industry $80 billion and destroy farms and regional communities across Australia. It's why there's been calls for further biosecurity measures to be implemented from farmers and from politicians.
US President Joe Biden has begun a high-stakes tour of the Middle East, his first visit to the region since taking office. His first stop is Israel, where he's reconfirmed the strong connection between the two countries. Later this week, he'll travel to Saudi Arabia. David Woywod reports.
Good morning. While reaffirming American support for the state of Israel, US President Joe Biden has declared he wouldn't rule out using force against Iran if it were to acquire nuclear weapons. The comments made as the president touched down in Tel Aviv, his first trip to the region as president, telling Israeli media the decision of his predecessor, Donald Trump, to rip up a 2015 nuclear deal meant Iran was now closer than ever to becoming a nuclear power.
Does that also mean, sir, that you would use force against Iran? Is that what that means?
That was the last resort, yes. Mm-hmm.
One Trump legacy Biden is happy to own, closer ties between Israel and its neighbours, inspecting the country's Iron Dome defence. A focus of this trip, according to the White House, will be bolstering ties between Israel and states like Saudi Arabia, all while, he says, US-Israeli relations have never been stronger.
It's bone deep. Generation after generation, that connection grows.
Earlier, Biden visited a Holocaust memorial. Laying a wreath, he wiped away a tear at one point as he spoke with survivors. It's a high-stakes foreign mission for the president at a time when domestic pressures, including high fuel prices, are dominating headlines at home. The president to use this trip to lobby oil producers in the region to ramp up oil production in the hope of lowering prices back home.
According to the Australian Medical Association, masks should return in WA if daily hospitalisations hit 350. Today we've recorded 6,535 new COVID infections. As it stands, there are 329 people with the virus in hospital, with 14 in ICU. The AMA says hospitals are struggling and the predicted peak is still about 6 weeks away. Australia's unemployment rate has once again fallen to a record 50-year low. New data shows 88,400 jobs were created last month, more than double market expectations, as labour demands remain strong across the country. It's pushed the national unemployment rate from 3.9% to 3.5% in June, the lowest unemployment rate since the early 1970s. Economists expect the rate to rise next year. Queensland has claimed Rugby League's State of Origin crown, grinding out a 10-point victory over the highly favoured New South Wales team in Brisbane. Queensland lost several key players to head knocks in the opening minutes before staging a remarkable second-half comeback.
Origin deciders in Brisbane haven't traditionally ended well for the Blues, and the start of Game 3 wasn't much better. New South Wales losing Cameron Murray to a head clash.
Oh, just a head clash.
There was no softening up period. Selwyn Cobbo collecting the hip of teammate Patrick Carrigan. Headaches too for the coaching staff. The pain only deepening for Maroons mentor Billy Slater, losing Lindsay Collins straight after Cobbo.
Have you seen a start to an origin?
Not for a long time, with like this.
No Cameron Munster, no worries. Apprentice Tom Dearden playing the role of master.
Tom Dearden, the 21-year-old on debut, has put the Queensland centre Valentine Holmes over.
The old guard, Cleary and Luai, got the Blues up and running. Reinforcements came from another newcomer, Jacob Saifidi.
There's something cooking here. You bet it is. Jacob Saifidi scores the try for New South Wales.
Queensland hit back on the stroke of half-time. Then, a flashback to Origin's past. Matt Burton and Dane Gagai going toe-to-toe in an old-fashioned Origin stink.
They're both throwing the haymakers.
Well, Gagai got him.
Was there a cattle dog call?
Both players sent to the sin bin. Kalen Ponga with a cool head and some fancy footwork, giving the Maroons a 16-12 lead. With under 2 minutes remaining, Cleary tried one last roll of the dice. Ben Hunt quickly shutting that down.
Ben Hunt, he goes for the corner. Ben Hunt wins the Origin for Queensland.
The Maroons wrapping up the series with a 22-12 victory. Patrick Carrigan awarded the Wally Lewis Medal for Player of the Series. Matt Shervington, 7 News.
You're watching 7's Morning News live from Perth. Still to come, which Perth suburb has made it onto the list of the top 50 best places in the world? Plus, Britain's ruling party's final candidates in the running to replace Boris Johnson. And the remarkable archaeological find shedding more light on the Battle of Waterloo.
To know the news, you have to be there.
7 News was invited to record those precious final days.
Wherever it matters, we take you there.
This certainly isn't the end of the drama that has dominated British politics.
Know the news. 7 News at 6 o'clock.
Bill Cosby's fall from grace shocked the world. But you haven't heard the half of it. Now, a former teen victim proves her case in court to drop a major bombshell.
What happened within the walls of the Playboy Mansion? The exclusive interview with explosive consequences.
The dark side of Hollywood.
Only on 7 News Spotlight, Sunday.
With more to see, taste and do, there's more to Big Nights Out at Crown. Live a little at Crown.
Attention CPAP users. Dirty air can build up inside your reservoir, hose and mask. And cleaning them can be an expensive, difficult task. So to ensure your CPAP is clean, you need Clean Zone, the affordable, easy-to-use, portable CPAP sanitizer. Just press and Clean Zone automatically sanitizes every surface of your CPAP reservoir, hose and mask. With sanitizing ozone, no water, no added chemicals, no worries. It will help you breathe in healthy, clean air and sleep peacefully.
I used to bug him to clean the CPAP machine and I worried about how dirty it was.
But with the Clean Zone, I just attach it to the tube and within minutes it's clean.
We love the price too.
The secret is activated oxygen that is created by Clean Zone's internal ozone generator. Plus, it's lightweight, compact, and portable.
I looked at other CPAP cleaners, and when I compared quality and price, Clean Zone was my clear choice.
I can sleep with the peace of mind knowing that I'm breathing clean.
Clean Zone works with virtually all make and model CPAP machines. It's powered by a long-lasting rechargeable battery and is maintenance-free. Just press and Clean Zone does the rest. You've seen other CPAP sanitizers sell for over $400, but you won't pay that much. Call Global Shop Direct or go online now and get Clean Zone for the low price on your screen. You'll get the Clean Zone CPAP sanitizer with two hose adapters, the sanitizing zip bag, and a USB charging cord. Plus, as an added bonus, you'll also get the Clean Zone Deluxe Storage Bag. Clean Zone makes sanitizing your CPAP a breeze. But if you're not completely satisfied, just send it back within 30 days for a full refund of the product price. So you'll get the complete Clean Zone CPAP system plus the bonus deluxe storage bag, all for one low price. That's a great price for a great night's sleep. Call or go online to order your Clean Zone today.
Australia's most loved cheese.
Plenty of smiles in Frio this morning, with the port city finding its way into Time magazine's 50 greatest locations in the world. The only other Australian location to make the cut is Queensland's Great Barrier Reef. Other cities listed include Toronto and Copenhagen, as well as the International Space Station. Time magazine describes Fremantle as somewhere to eat, drink and be Aussie. A man and a woman are in custody over a shooting murder in Melbourne. A father was shot dead on a street in Fitzroy on Tuesday. Here's Blake Johnson.
Two significant moves for police. They have found the Audi thought to be involved in the shooting and they have arrested two people. They are a 43-year-old man and a woman who's 21. They were nabbed in the suburb of Noble Park, about 35 minutes drive southeast of where the shooting happened in Fitzroy. The car was found much closer in South Yarra. Brian Laidlaw is the man who was killed. He was shot in the back around 4:15pm on Tuesday, just a few hundred metres from the local police station. The victim lived on the street where he was shot, Napier Street. Police say he'd been in that Audi for a few minutes, got out quickly and started to run. That's when he was shot by someone who got out of that car. It's not clear how many shots were fired, but police say the victim is not linked to an organised crime gang. But it does continue a recent gun violence trend in Melbourne. At least 18 shootings this year, 8 people killed by guns already. That was the total number of gun deaths in our city for the entirety of last year.
Sri Lanka's Prime Minister has declared a state of emergency, telling the military to do whatever is necessary to restore order in the face of fierce protests. Police have fired water cannons and tear gas at crowds. Protesters are demanding the Prime Minister and President step down immediately as the country grapples with a devastating economic crisis. The President has fled on a military jet to the Maldives and is expected to resign today. Archaeologists have made an incredible discovery in Belgium, uncovering the bones of soldiers and horses from the Battle of Waterloo in 1815. Remains from the Napoleonic clash have been found alongside entire skeletons and limb bones, all unearthed at the site of a British field hospital near Brussels. Britain's Conservative Party MPs have begun the process of choosing a replacement for Prime Minister Boris Johnson. The first round of voting has narrowed the list of candidates to 6. Hugh Whitfeld has more.
The former Chancellor Rishi Sunak is leading the pack, but there is a new dark horse snapping at his heels. 358 Conservative Party MPs are spending the next couple of days whittling 8 candidates down to just 2 in a series of votes. The final 2 will face the Conservative Party membership, around 200,000 Britons, in a vote that will take a couple of weeks. In today's round, Rishi Sunak secured 88 votes, but not far behind on 67. A name you might not have heard of, Penny Mordaunt, a former defence secretary, albeit short-lived, under Theresa May. If she makes the final 2, the polls suggest she could be the next British Prime Minister, so popular that she is among the Tory party base. Foreign Secretary Liz Truss is still in the mix, but out Jeremy Hunt, who Boris Johnson defeated a couple of years ago in a leadership contest, and the current Chancellor, Nadeem Zahawi. Boris Johnson knows, of course, his days are numbered. Here he was in a boisterous House of Commons.
And I'm also proud of the leadership that I have given. And I will be leaving, Mr. Speaker. I will be leaving soon with my head held high.
And that was after the opposition leader, Keir Starmer, described the Prime Minister as, quote, totally deluded until the bitter end. And the end will come for Boris Johnson on September 6. His successor as Conservative leader will be announced the day before, but it's on September 6 Boris Johnson will go to see the Queen to resign, and then, likely about an hour later, the new Tory leader will see Her Majesty and become the new British Prime Minister.
Stay with us on 7. Sports coming up after the break, including West Coast coach Adam Simpson approached about a return to the Roos. Plus, Buddy Franklin's contract talks with the Swans hits a roadblock. And Brandon Stark withdraws from the World Athletics Championships.
When Perth wakes up, there's only one place to see breaking news.
Sunrise.
Perth and Mandurah petrol prices have soared to a record high.
Perth's only live and local morning news. Sport and weather every 30 minutes.
Our City of Light has been shining green and gold.
Sunrise. Perth's number one. Be careful. Your favourite lovable chaser is secretly out to crush you.
Next.
New The Chase, weekdays on 7.
The friendship between a 19-year-old and a 66-year-old can become such a close, neat relationship when you're working with them every single day.
You learn a lot from them.
She's a really good communicator.
She's very funny. She's really good.
The fact that she wants to get her hands dirty, but she also does that little bit extra to help out as well.
She makes the room happy.
It's
Australia have most price friendly with crazy deals. Like a ridiculous 20% off Asus and Lenovo computers. 700 of this Asus 13-inch laptop. 250 of this Lenovo 15-inch notebook crunched to 649. And 400 of this Asus 14-inch laptop. JD, you've done it again.
Your sanctuary awaits at Garden Towers by Finbar. Luxurious apartment living amidst majestic surrounds in the heart of East Perth. Flaunting lush residences, shimmering views, resort-style amenities, and a thriving food and beverage precinct. This is glamorous rooftop cocktails. This is sunset streetside dining. This is Garden Towers. Buy now with only $5,000 deposit. Plus, you may be eligible to save up to $50,000 in stamp duty. Visit gardentowerseastperth.com.au.
Welcome to Business Space, home base for business.
Hi, I'm Peter McLennan.
Everything a business needs, everything a business needs to know. Office furniture fit-outs, cafe and restaurant furniture, shop fittings and fit-outs, shelving, racking, storage, business machines and business advisory services.
Cobram Estate is truly one of the world's great extra virgin olive oils, and it's the only one I use in my restaurant.
I've always had a deep respect for good produce and for sharing it with the people you love.
Every 40 olive trees on our groves offset the carbon footprint of one person.
The way you feel is closely linked to your diet. This is the only oil I use and recommend.
Cobram Estate, Australia's most loved extra virgin olive oil.
When I found out that Budget Direct had won Money Magazine's Insurer of the Year award for a record 6 years in a row, that's when I knew they'd solved it, mate. It's time you switched to Budget Direct.
Former teammates of Adam Simpson, key North Melbourne people, have approached the Eagles coach about a move back to the Roos. West Coast CEO Trevor Nisbet says Simpson is going nowhere and won't be coaching North next year. In a statement, Nisbet said, "As a club, we know what we have to do and he will be with us." Buddy Franklin's wife Jacinta has indicated they've got no interest in moving out of Sydney. Contract talks with the Swans have hit a roadblock, with the superstar yet to agree on the right value for another deal.
We're really happy in Sydney at the moment, and you know, we've got our life set up here, so yeah, we'll just have to see what happens. He still feels like he's got lots of great footy and he feels so good. He keeps saying, I feel like I'm 21.
Demons coach Simon Goodwin says it wasn't worth the risk to play his star midfielder Clayton Oliver after thumb surgery, who's been ruled out this weekend. Reigning champion Tadej Pogacar surrendered the yellow jersey in the first serious mountain test of this year's Tour de France. Pogacar cracked on the final brutal climb of Stage 11, Denmark's Jonas Vingegaard powering clear to claim victory and the overall lead.
It's time to soak it in. He maximises the gains. Vingegaard victorious.
Vingegaard is now more than 2 minutes in front of Pogacar. Aussie high jumper Brandon Stark has withdrawn from the World Athletics Championships in Oregon. The 28-year-old, who finished fifth at the Tokyo Olympics, is battling a foot injury. Stark remains hopeful of defending his Commonwealth Games title in Birmingham at the end of the month. Take care on the roads today. It's looking like a wet afternoon around the suburbs. I'll have your full weather forecast after the break.
This guy who's a kitchen bayer.
That's how I left the Logies that last time.
With the front bar back on Thursdays, things are getting wild.
What is going on?
But just wait until the Jarman brothers drop in.
Well, don't give the whole show away.
A crazy night at the front bar. Tonight, 8:30 on 7.
Tonight, I'll be eating hot, cheesy pizzas with my ZFFs.
Cheers, mate.
Okay, Paris, take it off.
OMG, so cute.
And don't worry, it's got that moat.
Super high fences.
No snake will ever get in here. Oh.
No.
Oh, well, that's the food chain.
How good ICS Flex 50 Extras?
I know. You can choose your own provider and still get 50% or more back up to your annual limits.
Ugh. Wait a sec, I don't get that.
Oh, no wonder you're so crabby.
Check out HBF today.
What's going on?
eBay Tuesdays. Heaps of deals every Tuesday.
How are those reports going?
On things like noise-cancelling headphones.
We should get sushi, girl.
The secret for soups is simple. The more ingredients, the more flavour.
Get real. Campbell's Real Stock is packed with real flavour and real ingredients.
Voila! Yay!
Real flavour, real easy. Get real with Campbell's Real Stock.
At We Want Your Wheels, we buy everything on four wheels. So avoid all the stress of selling your car privately or trading your car in. We'll buy it on the spot, pay out your finance, and even make sure you get home. We buy any make or any model because we want your wheels.
The all-new Google Pixel 6 with the best camera on a Pixel yet. Make motion silky smooth with Motion Mode. And blurry faces go bye-bye with Face Unblur. It's smart enough to make photo bombers disappear with Magic Eraser. On the first ever all-Google phone, Google Pixel 6, from $999 for all you are.
What's the plan, Robbo?
I'm just having a couple of same-game multis.
You know you can play it safe, right?
What are you thinking?
Well, first, use a bookie with safer gambling tools. And then set a deposit limit. It'll help keep your betting in check.
Done.
Nice shot, mate.
Having a bet? Have a game plan. Set a deposit limit. A message from Responsible Wagering Australia.
Checking the weather now. It's currently 17 degrees in our city. Wet around the suburbs today. The chance of a thunderstorm and gusty winds this afternoon as well. Expecting around 20 degrees for the metro area, including in Midland and Swanbourne. Showers should ease tomorrow afternoon, another top of 20 degrees. Then the chance of morning fog to start your weekend on Saturday. The slight chance of showers forecast for Sunday, with temperatures around that 20 degree mark, expected right across next week. That's Seven's morning news for now. Our next bulletins are at 4 and 6 o'clock, but we'll keep you updated throughout the day too. I'm Syan Vallance. Thanks for your company. Stay with us now for our afternoon movie, Dolphin Tale.
Friday, July 20th.